Someone asked me to do John first. Let's do John first. John Doyle, I guess, is upset because recently, I believe on 9/11, George Bush gave some remarks. George W. Bush, who is a war criminal, by the way. So I don't like George W. Bush. He's a terrible human being who has resulted in the deaths of countless civilians in the Middle East. Not to mention, of course, people who went over there at the behest of the United States military to kill said civilians. And then, you know, got killed or have PTSD that's going to be with them for the rest of their lives. You get it. George W. Bush, basically, awful, awful person. Anyway, George W. Bush compared the January 6th dumbass insurrectionist weirdos to 9/11 terrorists, which I do find funny. So John's not happy about that. Let's see how he reacts.
And we have seen growing evidence that the dangers to our country can come not only across borders, but from violence that gathers within. There is little cultural overlap between violent extremists abroad and violent extremists at home. But in their disdain for pluralism, in their disregard for human life, in their...
I feel like this is the meme from I Think You Should Leave, where it's, we're all looking for the guy who did this. Yes, George W., I'm sure you and your politics had nothing to do with the growing right-wing extremism in the country over the last 20 years. You're fine.
Determination to defile national symbols. They are children of the same foul spirit. And it is our continuing duty to confront them.
The real question is, who shot Hannibal? I don't get that reference. Is he gonna change his intro? Because this doesn't really fit his vibe anymore.
John Doyle in. Heck off, commie.
Also, I appreciate that his parents let him put a cigarette in his mouth for 5 seconds to film that.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Heck Off, Commie. I wanted to do a two-part series this week about the ties between liberalism and Satanism and
Oh, I'm excited for that one.
Conservatism and Christianity, respectively, while we're still in the wake of the new Texas abortion laws and the resultant meltdowns from the fluoride stare women who don't even live in Texas, learning that they won't be able to sacrifice their children at the altar of self-worship here in the Lone Star State anymore. But
every time I'm like, oh, yeah, John Doyle has a new video out, and then I go and click on the video, and then it's like, oh yeah, he's terrible. It's like it's a fresh experience every time. It's like I'm a character in Groundhog's Day other than Bill Murray. I just keep experiencing the same day, but I don't remember.
But then I found something that I wanted to use for the intro of that video, and it's going to require a lot of editing that I just would not have had time for because it's like an audio recording, and it would just be better if it were substantiated with evidence from contemporary American culture, like displayed on screen, even though everyone, you know, if you hear it, you'll understand why it's been totally vindicated. I don't know. I just get very particular about these things, okay? So we're going to delay that until next week, and then this makes more sense, too, right now since we just had the 20th anniversary of 9/11. And I've got some pretty good takes on that, so we'll...
I'm sure you do. Blackwing Hecty says they're talking about this meme. JFK, CIA. Why did Lee Harvey Oswald do that?
Just get those out now.
Holly Hoom says you're Sisyphus but hot, and he's bolder but more dense.
And then we'll do the two-part series next.
I'll keep pushing him up that hill.
Week, very epic, but when I talk about 9/11, I acknowledge that I probably sound pretty...
Was John Doyle even alive on 9/11? He just turned 21. He turned 21 prior to the 20th anniversary of 9/11. So, yes, but he definitely doesn't remember it.
Calloused? I don't mean...
Nick says, hey, what happened to his homophobic dissertation? Yeah, did he ever post that? Did he decide not to? Did he just put it on his website or do it privately so he didn't get his channel removed for that? Yeah, he never did do that, did he?
Mean to? I would imagine that's because I was like 2 years old at the time. I don't think anyone who either doesn't remember 9/11 or who wasn't alive for it can really understand the impact that it had on the country emotionally. So I would say, to give me the benefit of the doubt, just keep in mind that, you know, just because I'm not joining in with everyone else talking about how we can never forget how we were attacked because of our freedoms, you know, that doesn't mean that I don't understand how horrific that day was. It's just that I can't help but be honest about how I look at it 20 years later. So I will read to you the bullet points that I posted on Instagram about 9/11. You know, I used to be able to do this on Twitter, but then I got kicked off for advocating for participation in the democratic process like a good...
You doxed people, John. You doxed people. Hats off. That means I gotta put a hat or something on. Let's go. Which hat? You were just talking about Satanism, and they seem to think witches and Satanists are the same thing, so that seems to qualify. That'll do.
Little civic process enthusiast. So now I have to do this on Instagram, so you should definitely follow me because I post pretty good content over there too. But anyways, I said,
I've seen it.
The biggest takeaways from post 9/11 America are that, one, the peak of our post-war unity required a terrorist attack in New York City, and we'll never achieve anything even remotely close to that degree of unity again, even if something similar happened.
Post 9/11 unity was mostly an illusion put together by the media and the government in order to manufacture consent for the war in Iraq and Afghanistan. Like, after 9/11, hate crimes on minorities went through the fucking roof. The only people who felt like... the only people who felt more connected were, like, white people and black people, right? Like, seriously, it's probably a period in time where, like, racial tensions were lessened because the focus of racism tended to be on... people from the Middle East, or people who were mistaken for being from the Middle East. You know what I mean? So, post 9/11 unity, kind of fucking bullshit. Total fucking bullshit. Alumet, thanks for subscribing for 4 months. Rublem says, hearing about 9/11 from the baby facial who wasn't conscious during 9/11 will be as fun as teaching the elderly how to use a cell phone. And Colston says, oh god, he's a 9/11 truther now. Wait, why is city in scare quotes? Yeah, I don't know. E-Toon says, I don't remember 9/11, but whenever my family traveled down to my grandparents' house, we passed by these twin grain elevators that little me was always afraid of them turning into a flaming monster. Okay. Hydrate.
But now, two, the legal infrastructure established by the system to get the guys who hate you because you're free, and that's the NSA, DHS, Patriot Act, etc. Now that's going to be weaponized against you by the system because they hate you, which is why you're not actually free. And three, the American right used the greatest wave of patriotism and political support in the last 100 years to, checks notes, let a bunch of our people die in the sand for heroin trafficking and arms contracts. Meanwhile, our country has irreparably devolved into a glorified theme park. Where's the lie? Where is it? Hey, the lie must be like a WMD in Iraq, am I right? Because it's not there.
I think that's the best joke John Doyle's ever told.
No, not edgy enough. Is it like Larry Silverstein, the owner of the World Trade Center complex, who had breakfast every morning at the top of the North Tower, except coincidentally on September 11th when he had a doctor's appointment? Because it's not there.
Oh my god. Is he a 9/11? Oh no. John. Oh no. Ah! I should have put the tinfoil hat on for this.
Is it my channel when I explain why that's funny? Because it's not there. The point being that in almost 3 years now of political commentary, I have only missed once, arguably twice. That bracket of takes pertaining to post 9/11 America is completely accurate. Let us discuss why. Firstly, the unity factor. You can go back and watch the archives. How they used to dub Bush speeches over rock songs on radio stations. How Disney would have all the sitcom stars talk.
Yeah, it's fucked up. It was propaganda.
Talking about how much...
This, John and I might actually agree on this one. That is just outright fucking ridiculous propaganda. Because John is many things, but he is aware of this kind of thing from the establishment, right? I think where we differ is I think that kind of, like, propaganda shouldn't exist at all. Whereas I think John would just prefer it to be suited towards his political wants. Which are more isolationist and fascistic in nature. But That's a story for another day. Hats off. I guess I gotta switch hats. Do these. They're tinfoily.
They loved America in between segments of the shows and these little montages. That was the highest degree of unity that any of us had ever seen in our lifetimes and probably will ever see again. And now that's just completely
again,
gone.
Again, the unity was bullshit. There were people at the time, too, who were like, the wars are a bad idea. It's just that the media shut those people out and, like, basically labeled them as terrorist sympathizers. It was really fucked up. Stromboli for Wi-Fi says, my aunt was able to trace her family history on Ancestry.com to this church in front of the Twin Towers. Interesting. Too bad it's not Tuesday yet. Yeah. Nick says, one more month ready for our hockey player sub, baby. I am.
And in general, the trends show that our unity as a country has been dissolving for decades. Like, you can look at, for example, the trust levels between 1972 and 2012, dropping from 46 to 32%, about half the country saying they trust their countrymen, to about a third in 2012. And still, that was...
I think part of that has to do... This is a multifaceted issue in the United States, and some of it's warranted and some of it is not. The mistrust in government, I think a large part, and probably the biggest chunk, although I don't even know if I'd say it's the majority because it's such a, like, menagerie of different factors that go into it. But I think the biggest factor is people are materially worse off than they used to be. So if your life's going shitty and you feel like you don't have a lot of opportunity for the future and you think your country is, like, shitty, then you don't trust the government. If things are prosperous and things are going well for you on a personal level, financially and all that kind of thing, you're more likely to trust the government because things are going well. On top of that, other people mentioned in the chat, you have things like Fox News and other right-wing news, air quotes, organizations that have been sowing distrust in our nation's institutions for decades. On top of that, you have the general increase in access to knowledge with the internet, so people read about things that the government has done that are fucking terrible. So, like I said, part of it is completely warranted, and the war on terror and its utter fucking failure has absolutely been a huge part in decimating the trust as well. But it's a myriad of factors. It's a whole bunch of stuff. Trust amongst, like, fellow people in your country? A lot of that's probably the internet. We speak to each other more now. We speak to people outside of our personal bubbles. And we don't like that. Joey is strong. Thanks for 100 bits. I don't remember if I said that one.
That was 9 years ago. That was before Black Lives Matter went mainstream. Before gender theory went mainstream. Before cancel culture. Before Antifa. So
before cancel culture? John, do you not remember the Dixie Chicks? Since we're on the topic of 9/11. He probably doesn't remember the Dixie Chicks, actually. He was probably, like, 3 years old.
Just imagine where it's at now. I would guess something like 20%. That is not sustainable for a country. And we've been declining for a while because of many different factors, namely mass immigration from the third world and the post-industrial restructuring of the...
Yes, John. Clearly the problem with the United States' economy is immigration and not the fact that income inequality is the... worst it's been since, like, the 1920s. Yep, it's the people coming in from other countries.
The economy, but the point is that to get to a state where you could come together with your neighbor and say that you were proud to be an American, to wave the flag, to actually be unified as a country, that required, as we said, a...
random office stuff, hats in one of them.
Terrorist attack in New York City, and that...
Why is he emphasizing words? The first one I get, since he's going for some sort of conspiratorial bullshit thing, which I'm probably going to report. depending on how explicit he gets with it. At this point, reporting it would do nothing because he's being wink-wink with it. I don't understand why city is in, like, air quotes here. There's implied air quotes or italics, and I don't understand why. It is a city. It is literally a city, so I don't understand what his deal is. Nick says, then stop fucking up the third world, you jabroni. Good point.
Unity is never coming back. Even if something like that happened again, it just isn't because the people in this country are too nihilistic. I remember sitting...
Yeah, Baja's moving stuff.
Being in a classroom at my high school when the Parkland shooting was occurring, and I was following the coverage on Twitter, and you literally could not navigate through it without seeing all the memes that people were making about the shooting, which isn't to say that you can't joke about things like that, but it's just that the people in this country are not serious people anymore. Like, we largely have no...
John, I would imagine the kind of people who are making memes about a school shooting during the school shooting are probably fans of yours, not just randos. They're the kind of people who frequent, like, 4chan or 8kun or any of the other weird right-wing message boards. Like, people I know wouldn't be making jokes about a school shooting during the school shooting. This guy, Comet Fallen, says, there be a taking our jobs. John, probably? There be a taking our jobs. I know you're intentionally doing a thing, but...
No honor.
Trust and distrust in America? Let me see. Many Americans think declining trust in the government and in each other makes it harder to solve key problems. They have a wealth of ideas about what's wrong and how to fix it. Americans' trust has been shrinking. Federal government, 75%. Each other, 65%. Distrust in the federal government. So this is percent who believe America's trust has been shrinking. This is people who believe the trust has been shrinking, 75%, and in each other, 64%. What's the actual statistic, genuinely? All adults. Medium trusters, 41. High trusters, 22. Low trusters, 35. See, I think that makes more sense in order to break it up like that. Ooh, let's look at the more money. Yeah, the more money you make, the more trust you have in the government. Shock. My hypothesis was correct. I'm guessing based on, white people trust the government the most. Shocker. Anyway, I think medium trust makes about the most sense at this point. Like, how do I put this? Should you trust your government when they're telling you reasons why you need to go to war with a foreign country? You should probably be skeptical of that. But if the government's like, hey, there's a vaccine for a disease that's killing hundreds of thousands of people, millions of people globally. You should take this. Then yeah, you can probably trust the government on that. Just kind of depends on the specific thing.
We largely have no purpose. And if something like 9/11 happened again, there would be no unity. No, instead there would be an orchestrated consolidation of animosity against American patriots, and they would have the explanation for that all worked out in the media by the establishment in this country to...
Interesting that what he's saying automatically implies the next 9/11-like event would be done by right-wingers. I don't disagree, but it's weird that he's just saying that, considering it's him. Nick says, as an attorney, Tom says, it depends. Yeah.
To serve their ends at your expense. And my evidence for this is the second point, which is that when 9/11 happened, we established things like updated surveillance systems in the NSA. We established the Department of Homeland Security. We had the Patriot Act. We had all of that. And now that is all being weaponized against American patriots because they are simply defining you as a domestic terrorist.
John, if you don't want to be a domestic terrorist, stop hanging out with Nick Fuentes and planning domestic terror events like January 6th. Like, I'm not saying you're a part of that, but you're friends with Nick Fuentes, and Nick Fuentes was a part of that, so I'm kind of wondering if you had any sort of tangential relationship to that, you know? Maybe not. I hope you didn't. But just, usually people who aren't domestic terrorists aren't this concerned with being labeled as a domestic terrorist, is all I'm saying. Tucker White says, the sad thing is I can't completely dismiss the possibility that there was complicity with the U.S. government in regards to 9/11. I can't agree with you on that one. I just think it was incompetence. I just have no reason to think that it was anything other than the incompetence of agencies not communicating with one another. I think people overestimate, especially back in the 90s and early 2000s and prior, way overestimated the capabilities of the intelligence agencies to prevent stuff like that. Like, you just, what are they gonna do? You can't predict people if you don't have the information. Yeah. Plus,
they're so compartmentalized.
Yeah.
That you never, like, even government agencies that just do funding for scientific research, They're all compartmentalized. You don't intercommunicate with each other.
Yeah, not to mention the signal-to-noise ratio these days is worse than ever because everyone's communicating all the time with everyone. How do you parse that in order to find someone plotting some sort of event? So... Colston says John definitely has a file on him in the FBI. Maybe. Honestly, it wouldn't surprise me if I didn't. I don't think I do, but like if I found that out, I'd be like, oh, yeah. the FBI doesn't tend to like leftist type people. So it wouldn't surprise me if like Hassan at least has one. Like we're keeping track of Twitch lefties. Like, we know they have one on Bryson Gray, because Bryson Gray got visited by the FBI. So, it might sound crazy, but it's not that fucking crazy. Bloodwine TTRPG says, the U.S. reacted to 9/11 like a grade school bully being punched for the first time. Like, you got attacked. It was bad. The bad guys weren't caught right away. Tucker White says, I'm not saying I believe those conspiracies. I agree that it was largely government incompetence. I'm just saying that it wouldn't surprise me if all those conspiracies were actually true. I find even that difficult to say. Just because in this climate especially, it feels like an endorsement of said things. Like, I would put it this way. If that came out tomorrow that George W. Bush somehow knew it was going to happen but let it happen, would that surprise me? No, the guy's a fucking monster and so is his administration. Like, yeah, but I don't think that that's the most likely answer. Rublum said, I think the most likely answer is a shitty thing happened, and then people like Dick Cheney and other people who had the ear of the president convinced him to do things that would enrich all of them, because they're really fucked up people. Rublum says, you know, like the Patriots that assaulted the Capitol to overthrow the results of a Democratic election, or the Patriot that bombed an AT&T office with his camper bomb. American Patriot. Or the one that, like, a month ago or last month at some point rode up in front of the Library of Congress and was like, I have a bomb! I don't think he ended up having a bomb. I think he was just lying, but you get it.
The government is legitimate. Everything that they do is legitimate. Everything that they tell you is true. And if you disagree, you are a threat to them, which makes you a terrorist by definition, which enables them to weaponize that post.
John, no. You're terrorists because people like you tried to overthrow democracy in January. It was this year. It was this year. Prior to that, some other people similar to yourself with similar political affiliation, or not affiliation, similar political inclinations, tried to kidnap the governor of Michigan? Like, these are not isolated incidents, John. These are patterns of behavior. You and people like you have helped radicalize your audience intentionally in order to push for this sort of, like, terroristic action. Because you can't win in the court of public opinion because most people hate people like you and your shitty opinions. So instead, you've decided, the Taliban seemed to work out for them. So let's start doing the terrorism. Because you're assholes. Morok says, as a former employee of a three-letter agency, the amount of bureaucratic red tape we had to go through to talk to another agency was a real headache. And even then, actually getting what we needed was a nightmare, because nobody wants to share their info with each other. Yeah, to my understanding, prior to 9/11, like, the FBI and the CIA, one of them knew... Sorry, I'll get the bits that I missed in a sec. One of them knew that there was an imminent terrorist attack planning to take place on American landmarks. Like the World Trade Center and the Pentagon and the White House. And the other agency knew that there was terrorist intent on hijacking planes or something. There was some separation of information that if they had put it together, theoretically they could have figured it out. But even then, I think that hindsight, what are they going to stop every flight in the country? What every day? Like, what are they going to do? I don't know. I really don't. Honestly, if I've learned anything as I've gotten older, it's that I'm shocked stuff like 9/11 doesn't happen more often. I'm glad it doesn't. But, like, people can do that kind of stuff. People can do that kind of stuff. It's terrible, and they shouldn't. But, like, the world is kind of set up in a way that if you want to do something evil and destructive, you probably can. You shouldn't, and most people don't, which is good. But it's not that difficult, either. Colston says, there have been points in history where two different agencies were killing each other because they didn't know what was going on. Oh, lovely. Okay, let me see what the missed bits were. Nick says, wasn't part of lack of preparation because of the 2000 election debacle in Florida? I think there was something about it because the administration, like, they were getting held up on, I think, like, the Clinton administration was withholding some of the stuff that you do to, like, transfer over to the next administration from George W.'s administration in order to, you know, get ready for the presidency and taking roles of that. And that maybe impeded the W. administration's ability to mitigate or stop attacks like this. Again, though, I find claims like that to be hindsight. Like, I still don't know if they would have been like, aha, there's going to be a terrorist attack in the United States using airplanes. It will be this flight, you know? I guess you could argue maybe they would have gotten stricter and started banning, like, guns and knives and stuff, small knives. Actually, by the early 2000s, they might have already banned guns. I don't remember. But you used to be able to carry on guns on planes a long time ago. If you were law enforcement, I think. I don't know if it was for the general public. But, like, you could bring small knives and stuff on planes prior to 9/11, which is what they did. They used, like, box cutters to hijack the plane. Because people didn't take hijacking seriously. Prior to 9/11, when someone hijacked a plane, it was usually, like, a D.B. Cooper situation. They'd be like, land the plane, give me $100,000, and fly me to Cuba. Or something like that, you know? 9/11 was the first time that form of terrorism was really used in terms of hijacking a plane. Which completely changed the way air travel works for the worse. Most of it's security theater, but what are you gonna do?
Was 9/11 infrastructure against you, despite the fact that it was supposedly created to defend you or whatever? Which, by the way,
It is. Again, John, I agree that the overreach of the government in terms of, like, search and seizure, in terms of monitoring phone calls and phone metadata and stuff and text messages and all that, it's ridiculous. I agree. But when it gets used against, like, extreme right-wingers, or heck, extreme left-wingers, like, if there were tankies out there who were actually planning an overthrow of the United States government, I would hope the apparatus of American intelligence agencies would be able to catch that and stop them. The same for right-wing terrorists, which, by the way, actually happens. Tanky left-wing, like, terrorism is a rare thing. I don't even know the last time that happened. You could probably go back and, say there's been environmental terrorism. Like, you could argue that's left-leaning. People who, like, blow up, you know, animal testing labs or whatever. Stupid shit like that. Sure. But right now, that's not a problem we're facing en masse. Right now, we're facing a problem of extreme right-wing terrorism egged on by people like Donald Trump and yourself. That's just a fact everyone can see unless you're already in, like, a weird right-wing bubble. Tucker White says, also, let's be honest, how many terror reports do you imagine the CIA gets on a daily basis, even pre-9/11? Probably a lot. Stromboli says, sorry if you don't want to stream, but this is a, or to stream it, but this is a good example of the American airport security mindset pre-9/11. I can't because, you know, Beverly Hills Ninja. But yeah, if you watch old movies where they go to an airport pre-9/11, very different. I remember going on an airplane pre-9/11. I was very young, but I do remember it. It was different. It was quicker. Like, that was still at the, and I was at the age, and in fairness, they've gone back to doing this as far as I understand to some extent. But this was my first time on an airplane. And they still, like I said, they still do this now. I think they didn't do it for a while after 9/11, but I think they do it again. They, like, had me come up to the cockpit because I was a kid, and they showed me all the stuff, and they gave me those wing things. I don't know if they still do those for kids, but yeah, 9/11 really fucked a lot of stuff up. Andrew Dwyer tweeted video from inside the meeting. What meeting? If it loads. Video from inside the attempted overthrow of the Poway USD is extremely concerning. They were trespassing, telling board members they need to be arrested. They truly believed they were the new board. San Diego PD stood and watched them be sworn in. What the hell is this? I don't even know what this is talking about. People just trying to do a coup on the school board? What the fuck? I hate these people. Sure, Mike Marshall Stack, thanks for 6 months, says, I'll figure this out one day. Blackwing Hackety says, the last major left-wing terror thing was in the 80s. Bittergrin says, you also used to be able to wait for people at their gate and greet them as they got off the plane. Yeah.
We have lost their jobs. So,
what the fuck, America?
I promise you, is going to happen, provided that things don't change. Why would it not? As we saw in the beginning, George Bush literally took time out of his address to compare Trump supporters to the 9/11 terrorists. He literally said they're cut from the same cloth.
You are?
Can you find me a history book where one of the most powerful members of the ruling class, with the support and agreement and endorsement of the media or its contextual equivalent, says something like that? Says that a subset of the people over whom they govern are equivalent to the perpetrators of the deadly...
John, he was literally talking about the people on January 6th. He didn't say all Trump supporters or all right-wingers. He's George W. Bush. He's specifically talking about those people who did the terrorism. If you think he's talking about every Trump supporter, then you have a very, very poor opinion of Trump supporters. Worse than me, in fact. Which is impressive, because my opinion of Trump supporters isn't even in the toilet. It's beneath the sewer. So... Color by Emmy says, I used to work for Poway USD. That coup attempt was awful because the San Diego PD escorted the school board out and just stood around watching this fake quorum happen. What the fuck is wrong with the police? What the fuck is wrong with the police? Nick says, John Doyle be like, I resemble that remark.
Deadliest attack on their soil in recorded...
Did W even mention Trump's name? I don't think he did. I think he was just talking about specifically... the people on January 6th who did the terrorism
history, and they've established the necessary legal infrastructure to go after those people, and it's because they took some silly photographs and broke some windows. Or the
when John Doyle hears about Black Lives Matter protesters fucking up a Wendy's or something, it's a terrorist attack and they should be like hung or something. But when Trump supporters literally beat up the police, pepper spray them, and, like, chase Congress members and the vice president through the halls of Congress after breaking in and destroying property in the Capitol building, then it's just fun. It's just fun, guys. They're just taking pictures. It's just fun. It's just funsies. John, I streamed January 6th. Many of the people watching were probably here when I did. They were beating people till they were bloody, okay? And then Ashley Babbitt got shot because she was chasing the vice president. You can't gaslight this. You just can't. You got caught in HD. Like, what the fuck do you think you're gonna do? Talk your way out of this? Nick says, sir, that was a Wendy's. This is a fucking Capitol building of the United States of America. Color by Emmy says, hanged Hannah Antifa is already hung, winky face. Duggar White says, to be fair, I consider Wendy's far more sacred than McDonald's and other fast food joints. Wendy's is better than a McDonald's. I would agree.
The contextual equivalent being equally insignificant and inconsequential. And then, in the immediately succeeding chapter of this history book, everything just goes back to normal. But then it all went back to normal. Everyone just forgot about it and they moved on. No, it doesn't compute. These people hate you because you love the country that they're trying to destroy. It's really that simple. And that's why the third point especially resonates with me, which was that the...
J- John, you don't love the country. You love the imaginary, like, white ethno state that you've imagined in your head that doesn't exist. I know you were raised pretty well off, John, so in your head, like, everything's great until insert current social trend or insert current group that you don't like talking. But no, things have been shitty for a lot of people for a really long time. Only now is it getting bad enough that people like you are starting to see some negative outcomes because of the current state of the United States. Income inequality, shit like that, racial inequality. And the things that hurt you about it, it's not even like when we talk about racial inequality in the United States, it's not like white people are being discriminated against, okay? You're just not. I'm not. But it seems like you take umbrage with people even bringing up racial inequality, and to you that's enough of a slight to be like, ah, I hate BLM. They're awful. It's just wild. Sunday Starship, thanks for tier 1 for 5 months, says, I don't know what just happened. Blackwing Hecty says, everything was great until the Fire Nation attacked. True.
The American right used the greatest wave of
Sozin's Comet was an inside job.
Patriotism and political support of the last 100 years, and that's probably generous, but still, to Czech's notes, let a bunch of our people die in the sand for heroin trafficking and arms contracts. Meanwhile, our country has irreparably devolved into a glorified theme park. I really believe that. And the moment that occurred to me was actually last spring. I think I was in this downtown area, and there were lots of really nice shops and restaurants. And this area actually used to be like a nice area, you know, pretty safe area. People would bring their families there all the time, etc. And I'm looking at the people who are there now, and they're all from the third world. Like, they're all...
He's literally just saying this used to be a nice area, but then non-white people started coming. What the fuck?
They're all wearing the traditional clothing from the countries to which they actually pledge allegiance. They're all...
Oh my god, John, shut your fucking racist mouth.
That occurred to me was actually last spring. I think I was in this downtown area, and there were lots of really nice shops and restaurants. And this area actually...
Report, 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 report. Wow, typos. Typos galore. Oops, my fingers tripped. And oops, they tripped again.
It used to be like a nice area. You know, pretty safe.
Colston says, this guy is getting too mask off. He'll be going the way of Fuentes soon. I wish. Tucker White with 30 bits. I corrected immigrants to immigrates. Oh my god, of course I did. YouTube should get it. This guy come up fallen and says, please give us a link to report this racist bastard. Oh no, my fingers are clumsy again.
Up, shut up, shut up!
I've said this before, and I think the trend continues. What timestamp is it? 7:13. So John, I think he's been hanging around other far-right extremists too often, because he's getting more and more mask off. Like, he used to be pretty good at just doing the dog whistles, right? He just did dog whistles, and it was really hard to catch him out and, like, report the stuff he said because he was dog whistling. Because I think we all have this, like, general... Zeitgeist means, like, spirit of the age. So that's not really what I mean by this, but you'll understand kind of what I mean. We all have a general idea of what the zeitgeist is, and what is appropriate to say in general public, right? To be considered, you know, not an asshole or not racist or whatever. Hopefully that's not difficult, because hopefully you're not racist. But John and someone like him, because he is racist and because he is a piece of shit, have to be very careful about what they say and being mindful of where that zeitgeist is and what's appropriate to say and what isn't. But he's been spending so much time around exclusively right-wing people, far right-wing people like Fuentes. To him, saying He thinks immigrants from other countries are dirty and shouldn't be in a shopping center around him. He thinks that's a dog whistle because in his brain, he's thinking way worse words to use to say that. So to him, that is a softening of his position, but he's so far right that he doesn't understand that even the softening of his position is not considered okay. Anyway.
Safe area. People would bring their families there all the time, etc. And I'm looking at the people who are there now, and they're all from the third world. Like, they're all wearing the traditional clothing from the...
713 is the time tramp. 713 is the timestamp.
Countries to which they actually pledge allegiance. They're all speaking the languages of the countries from which they originate.
They can, John. There's not an issue with that. That's not even uncommon in American history. When people immigrate from other countries to the United States, first-generation immigrants often primarily speak their native tongue. Then they have children who are bilingual. Then those kids have kids, and generally speaking, not even generally, just historically speaking, then by the third generation, they speak English primarily. I mean, honestly, by the second generation, they do primarily, but often they're bilingual because they speak to their parents in a native language. But by like the third or fourth generation, that's less common. And you just see English most of the time. I'm not saying that's across the board. There are many people who, you know, teach their kids multiple languages, and that's awesome. That's great. It's good for them. Makes you smarter or something. I don't know. I can barely speak English, so. But the point I'm trying to make is, John, you think these things are issues because you're fucking racist. No normal person hears what you have to say about this and goes, yeah, he's got a point. No, you're just a bad person. Geek-o-graphs, thanks for following.
And I'm watching them, you know, they're littering, they're letting their kids run around, knocking stuff over, screaming, and they're...
And as we know, no red-blooded American has ever littered.
They're all standing in line outside of these...
Nick with 30 bits. That's a cute kitty.
Designer stores. They're all standing outside of Tiffany's and Louis Vuitton and Gucci.
Wait, John Doyle is claiming that an area with a Tiffany's, a Louis Vuitton, and a Gucci is a bad area now because there are people there who aren't white? John, those aren't bad areas. You're just racist. That's a nice area with more than just white people. Holy shit. He literally defines how good or bad an area is by the race of the people in the area, with no other factors. Oh my god. Holy shit. Junkyard Days, thanks for 4 months. Colston says, John's self-centered enough to think whenever someone's speaking another language, it's about him.
But none of them are coming out with anything. Like, they're literally just waiting in line to go into the store for the experience. So I asked one of the employees, hey, does anyone actually buy anything down here anymore? She goes, no, people don't come down here to shop anymore. And so all of our sales are just happening online. And that's when it clicked for me. Like, oh, this country is literally just a glorified theme park.
John, that's because people buy things online. That has nothing to do with immigrants, if you even talk to that person. Which, who knows? It's John Doyle. He could just be making shit up. But John, people buy things online because it's convenient. Not to mention, people will go into stores and look at things and then buy them online later. That's not uncommon. So they can either try them on, or just get a look at what they look like in person, and then they sometimes make a decision later and buy it online. Or they just use the brick-and-mortar store as basically a showroom. It's fine. Who cares?
Nobody has any respect for it. Nobody has any knowledge of how to create something like this, or knowledge of the brilliance and sacrifice that went into making something like this. They just...
Do you know the blood, sweat, and tears that it took to build this Tiffany's store? That Gucci bag was... That Gucci bag was sewed together by straight white men in America. It definitely wasn't sewn together by basically slave labor in the third world. Oh my god.
Just show up and get whatever they can out of it. And these people send their kids to American schools and they vote. And over time, the ideas get more popular in the mainstream that America is evil and depressive. We're colonizers, as if giving them access to the greatest societal amenities and systems ever created in the history of the planet for nothing in return.
For nothing in return. John, when you do that by force, it doesn't matter. Fucking matter.
Except for maybe like a potential reduction in our weird pseudo-masochistic guilt was really such a disservice to them. It's a theme park. And maybe it's been a-
John, recognizing the negatives of colonialism is normal. Recognizing the negatives of colonialism and imperialism in general is good. It's unironically being like... You should be happy the Romans took over your town and started crucifying people. Because they brought irrigation. Like, John, we're aware that sometimes when people invade other nations, that they sometimes bring amenities. That doesn't make the invasion okay. I don't know if you know that. Because you could bring them those amenities without force. You could be like, hi, we're from another country. We have these things. Would you like these things? We could give them to you or trade for them. When you go and you're like, this country's our country now. Or go to a country and be like, we would like to buy some people, please. Not okay. Not okay. Strumbully for Wi-Fi says, if Adam and Eve wanted me to buy their vibrator in their brick and mortar stores, then why do they give me 80% off with a coupon online, especially when they throw in 3 DVDs, lube, and a gift for her? I call conspiracy.
A theme park for a while, but at least it used to be a cool theme park.
Like an ad read.
Park, right? At least we used to have
Adam and Eve sponsor me.
Like Captain America for a mascot. Who's our mascot now? What mascot?
John, it's a country, not a sports team. We don't need a mascot.
I could best represent the United States of America in 2021. Probably like transgender George Floyd with dementia. Or actually, no, just Captain America, but gay now. That's our mascot.
Okay, we can have gay Captain America.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
And we've got bright lights, we've got entertainment, we've got corn syrup and pesticide.
I find that funny, too, considering, like, John, normal, like, Steve Rogers Captain America wouldn't even like you. Much less gay Captain America from the United States of Captain America comics that are, I think, still ongoing.
Could I have one of your earphones so I could listen while I'm on the other side of the office?
Okay.
Thank you.
Felix Night Owl says, if he thinks we shouldn't be using the internet in such a way we never leave the house, why isn't he doing his show live at a bar or next to a dumpster at an alley? Simple Cat Girl says, first of all, fuck this guy. Second, during the pandemic, a lot of people had to learn how to sew clothes through TikTok and YouTube. Third, the stores he lists are expensive as shit. Also, most people are trying to buy clothes from more local designers and support ethical stores. Also, some people just like the stores as fun to look around. Yeah. Has he not heard of window shopping? Or just, you know, shopping in general? You don't necessarily buy stuff. Tucker White says, also, this America's a theme park line isn't even a new talking point. George Carlin was making similar arguments back in 2005. He might have just ripped it off from there.
And phytoestrogens, you don't even have to pay for parking. Just a per mile tax on the way here, right? Dude, we could have reversed all of that. George Bush literally had the highest approval rating in recorded history. His word was gospel and we did nothing with it because he's complicit in all of this and also very stupid. I am unironically of the opinion that if Buchanan had won in 92 and if Norm Macdonald, may he rest in peace, hosted The Daily Show or one of its equivalents, this country would be on the right track. I really... believe the potential of those two men was that great. But that didn't work out, so we had to put our faith in people like George Bush. And we will discuss that speech excerpt momentarily along with a few other points on this topic, but first, we actually have some good news. It just keeps flowing, which is that we have yet another fantastic addition to the Heck Off Commie sponsor roster.
No, I don't think Norman McDonald liked John. I really don't. Norm MacDonald had some questionable material, but overall, he's a funny guy, you know? But I don't think he'd like John. I think he would think John is a dweeb. I think he would think John is a dweeb with delusions of grandeur, and I think he would call him out on that shit. Now, in fairness, I don't think Norm MacDonald would like me either. I don't think Norm MacDonald likes most people. He was Norm MacDonald, but I don't get the impression he would like John very much.
Can you tell that I want you to be armed yet? Is it obvious? Here's the thing. If you're a gun owner, you know that whether you're at the range or carrying a pistol in your everyday life, one aggravation is always having the right mag carriers on hand, depending on what firearm you are using that day, because as you know, you gotta change it up. Variety is the spice of life. Sometimes you wanna be on the news talking about how you use the P365 to kill the bad guy. Other days you might wanna talk about how you use the XD45 to kill the bad guy. It all gets very confusing. Well, you would
be skipping the ads.
Pitbull.com, Pitbull11. In fact, many of them are saying to what we were talking about earlier. Here's how I really know that no unity is possible. This is the most obvious indicator to me. Trump supporters, aka anyone to the right of Hillary Clinton, are being called domestic terrorists.
No, John. There are people further right than Hillary Clinton who aren't necessarily Trump supporters. So no. And no, John, the people that are getting called domestic terrorists are domestic terrorists and people who work with domestic terrorists or do stochastic terrorism. I don't know if you're on a list somewhere, but that would be on you, if I'm gonna be entirely honest, based on the company you keep. And the fact that you're constantly riling up your audience and trying to get them to, you know. Anyway.
And they are literally comparing January 6th to 9/11. They're styling it as 1/6 precisely for that reason, because in their minds, it's just like 9/11. In fact, many of them are saying it's even worse than 9/11, that it was an even worse day for America than 9/11 because it was an attack on our democracy from within.
Can we not try and play, like, I'm not a fan of trying to be like, this thing's worse than that thing in regard to, like, terrorist attacks. They're both bad for different reasons.
Within these,
Mike Mack says, Jesus, guns, white privilege, and the American way. Long ago, the Americans lived in harmony. Then everything changed when the... Oh, no. I don't want to read this. I know you're only jokingly saying that because John is racist, but no, I'm not reading that.
People should be put in jail. I mean, literally, they should be put in jail. I think the definition of treason, which is not constitutionally protected speech as outlined by our founding fathers,
treason has to be like during a time of war and aiding, abetting an enemy.
I think it should be expanded.
I'm just saying, there's specific definitions. You might mean sedition. Felix Night Owl says, why are BLM and Antifa supposed to take responsibility for every single riot or vandalism, but these gun-worshipping, gun-fetishized pieces of shit are not responsible for every mass shooting across the nation because they're hypocrites. That's why.
Banded to include anyone who at any point has compared January 6th to 9/11 in a serious manner because it's treasonous. It incites violence against conservatives as...
Oh my God. Tucker White says January 6th wasn't worse than 9/11. Al-Qaeda actually knew what it was doing. January 6th is basically on par with soccer, hockey, hooliganism. I would say we're talking about intent versus, application. But again, not having that discussion, because I don't think that's a fruitful conversation to have in any way, shape, or form. Daddy Sume says, I've arrived, my loves. Oh God, not John Doyle. I'll be back later. Also, free speech, John Doyle. John Doyle, all about free speech. Incredibly upset he was banned from Twitter for doxing people. Wants politicians locked up for comparing one terrorist attack to a different terrorist attack in a way that he's not happy with. So, that's nice. Simple Cat Girl says, can I say that right-wingers' thinking just sounds so pathetic and sad? Like, I'm a black demisexual woman, and I can't imagine living every day thinking that the government wants me dead and that I have to constantly fight a thing that's not happening. Yeah. They gotta keep their people riled up. They want more acts of violence to happen. Which they will. Which is going to suck.
As we've seen countless times, and I think these people should be put in prison for exactly 2,977 days. Oh, but John, that's not what America's about. You're right. I forgot. Let's keep doing it your way. Oh, hey, theme park entrance is right up ahead, right? If we use the governments against our political opposition, how are we better than the left? That's not even what I'm saying. If I wanted to target my political opposition with the power of the state, I would just have my DOJ crack down on child pornography to achieve the same effect. The point, hyperbolic as it may be, is that a serious country would...
Which political party ran a literal pedophile for Senate a couple years back? 4 years ago? Roy Moore? Anyone? Which one currently has someone in Congress who is under investigation for child sex trafficking? Which one? I keep forgetting. Matt Gaetz? Anyone? No, okay.
Would not grant influence to people who say things like that. And people have always said stupid things, but this is different. This isn't just, ha, what if an elephant was blue? It's not even, ha, I'm a woman with a penis. This is rhetoric that is deeply, deeply insulting to thousands of American families, thousands more American families who lost people in the resulting wars, to tens of millions of families.
John, you literally inferred earlier, or implied rather, sorry. You implied earlier that you think the 9/11 terrorist attacks were a conspiracy that the government did. And you're going to pretend in the same video that you care about respecting the memories of the victims of 9/11? Go fuck yourself. Oh, he can't. Shit.
Also, allegedly, Lauren Boebert's husband exposed himself to a teen in 2004 and was arrested for it.
Fun.
Who supported Donald Trump as a presidential candidate, and to our country as a whole. People who say things like that should not be allowed to hold any position of influence in government, in media, or in education.
Oh, cool. Are we doing this now? John, I don't think people with your opinions should hold any power in governments or media or education. Are we just saying things that are unconstitutional now? Awesome.
Because we are down so bad. I have to compensate by taking things to the extreme because we are down so bad. I apologize. I don't mean to alarm anyone. I'm just negotiating. I have to call for them to be imprisoned so that the counteroffer is just that they're not allowed to be teachers and...
No one's listening to you, John. Like, you have a pretty decent fan base of right-wing nutbags, but, like, no one actually takes you seriously in power. You don't even have, like, Dave Rubin levels of support, so... Joey is strong, says, is transphobia reportable? Probably. Uh-oh, my finger slipped again. Why does it keep hitting Control V? God damn it.
Politicians and stuff like that anymore. If you're that anti-American, then you should not be platformed or employed anywhere that receives tax dollars from American families. That makes sense to me. But back to the W thing.
He still hasn't talked about vaccines. The silence is deafening. I have a feeling he's definitely vaccinated. I've said this before. John's a fascist, and he's wrong politically, and he's evil. But I don't think he's stupid, at least not in the way that some of the other people I cover I think are stupid. So I think John's probably definitely vaccinated. But I also think he recognizes a lot of his audience probably aren't and are against the vaccine, so he just doesn't want to bring it up. It's a guess. I don't know, though. Nick says, maybe your hand is Texan and thinks control V means control vagina. B plus.
I really hated that speech he gave. The audacity of basically condemning the people who rallied behind you, who fought and died for your wars and for your father's wars, who defended you, to come out on the 20th anniversary of 9/11 and basically call them equal to the people who perpetrated the 9/11 attacks is just so purely dishonest and evil. That idea, it is so evil that that could only have spawned in a meeting in Washington, D.C. I felt like Syndrome watching that because, you know, George Bush has always been stupid, but he was charming, right? Like, he would just say stupid things. It became a meme. You know, W became a meme. I remember I used to have a W tank top with a picture of him on it flipping the bird. And this...
That tracks.
Spirit of it was basically like, hell yeah, brother, W says these colors don't run. But then he comes out, he starts talking about our democracy and calling his former supporters foul-spirited. And it's just me and my W tank top, like, you can't trust anyone, especially your heroes. And it's so true, but the better lesson is just never trust anybody who is presently able to fraternize with those who you know to be your enemies. It really is that simple. Like, there's a reason that Donald Trump is not in the club, but George Bush is. And it's
because he's an asshole and everyone hates him? Stochastic terrorism doesn't help. Blackwing Hecate says, maybe your hand is a big fan of third-person shooters set in secret 3LA-type org and TV show about secret alien invasions. That one's too specific for me. C-.
father was too before he went hot tub mode. So I guess the summary is that we should seriously be sounding the alarms right now, because the rhetoric that is coming from our own governments on that day of all days too is so alarming. Like, things really seem to be accelerating at a level that even I can't believe sometimes. You know, we always hear about the frog in the pan, right? This idea that over time the levels are going to just slowly increase.
It's a frog in a pot, you idiot.
Increase in intensity.
You're boiling it.
Intensity until before you know it, you're boiling to death. That's true in theory. I think that may have even been true a few decades ago, but now it's at a point where they have consolidated so much power, both in terms of absolute power and institutional representation, that now it seems to be more like frog in the blender, right? Where everything is just happening so fast that you don't even have time to react. You're basically just like, I think I might be in a blender right now. And then it turns on and it turns out you were right, but it happened so fast that you couldn't even do anything about it. I think that's a lot more accurate, at least now. But that being said, when we take power, which we will, because as we talked about in, I think, the last video, this system really is too incompetent and chaotic to ever be sustainable long term. And the things that they put in place to pacify and numb us into being oblivious to what they've done to our nation, widespread drug and alcohol abuse, pornography.
How old is he? 21, 22. I don't remember if he had another birthday. 21, I think. Blackwing Hecate says, and yes, I made sure to do some stretching before that reach. Speedy Yoshi says, I'm pretty sure Trump wouldn't show up to a former president's thing because he's a narcissist and would be like, no, I'm still going to be president. President, you Nile, you losers.
Pornography, obesity, mass media, consumerism, all of that is being abandoned, not in mass, but by lots of good people who realize that they effectively are weapons. And those are the people to whom George W. Bush and all of his gay friends are going to have to answer. They're going to have to...
hold on. That's reportable.
For the people to whom George W. Bush and all of...
My spelling sucks.
All of his gay friends are going to have to answer. They're going to have...
Stone Corbell says, proofread your bits messages. Please do. You're spending money on them. I'd like to be able to read them.
Have to answer to our guys, the guys that we put in charge of our very own Truth and Reconciliation Commission once the chips are down. And things are going to happen to them. Oh, what's that, George? You're worried? Hey, if you've got nothing to hide, you shouldn't be worried, right? Right, Patriot Act George? I find your lack of trust in the plan disturbing, President Bush. He gets sent to a re-education camp in Duluth or Billings to learn about our great leader, Mike Lindell. He's in 23-hour lockdown, padded cell. The pads are made of MyPillow material. They've got the logos and everything. I have no idea where this is going. I don't even know what this means. To be honest, I kind of checked out after we debuted the concept of transgender George Floyd with dementia, to be honest, but yeah. Just another day in the globalist American empire, right? Hey guys, if you like this video, leave it a thumbs up.
John Doyle is... the trajectory is so bad at this point that I can't even imagine if he has a YouTube channel in 5 years, what could this channel even be in 5 years? Like, what the fuck is this? Daddy Sume says, I will not proofread shit, Hannah. Well, fuck you. Speedy OG says, do you think John Doyle will ever get a single video taken down? Probably not. I mean, I hope so. I hope his channel gets banned, but, you know. Tucker White says, I'll proofread my bits messages when you take it from my cold dead hands.
Up, leave it a comment, subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications so that you are notified when I post, and of course, share the video with a friend. That's always important. Do you want to hear my impression of Tom DeLonge playing at a anti-secession concert to fundraise for anti-secession NGOs in 2025? He's going to go... This is hypothetically after Mark Hoppus survives cancer, which he will. We're all praying for him. And then they come back. They're playing with Matt Skiba as their fourth member. And he's going to go, this song's about America. It's called Stay Together for the Kids. That's how Tom DeLonge talks. But anyways, thank you so much for very few will understand that. That's very esoteric. You know, you really kind of have to know a few things to even understand what I'm talking about. I'm just going to keep that's the goal for the intro. Just keep talking until the only person who knows what I'm talking about is me. That's the goal. Just get that esoteric and then blame it on everyone else. I'm too smart. You don't get it because I'm too smart. It's not because it's nonsense. It's just because you guys don't.
John's doing the ironic thing where he'll be like, ironically say he's smarter than everyone else in order to lampshade the fact that he's an actual person who's so full of himself that he thinks he's smarter than everyone else. It's a very 21-year-old thing to do, is all I'm saying. Blackwing Hecate says, typo-ness is next to Hannah-ness, though. Tucker White with a link. Like, I'm pretty sure you could go back to early Bible... I'm pretty sure you could go back to early Bible Reloaded days, and I probably made similar jokes when I thought it was hot shit and way smarter than I actually am. Stromboli for Wi-Fi says, I just want to see a guerrilla-style bit of footage of a hot white chick hits on John and he just shits his pants and runs home. Rublum says John's comedy air quotes act wouldn't be allowed in Texas because that was an abortion. That joke gets an A. Seriously though, John's awful.
Get it, you're not on my frequency. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. May God bless America.
So that's bad. There's a variety of things that are reportable in that video. Oops, 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 oops. So that's the end of this segment.